Hey everybody, welcome to Monday with Michelle at OutLateButGreat. This week's topic was set by Jim, and it is as follows. Discuss how the issues of self-esteem, internalized homophobia or transphobia, and self-acceptance have impacted you as both a closeted LGBTQ person and an open out-of-the-closet person. And this topic could not come at a better time, actually, because it's been something that my partner and I have been talking about a lot. As you know from my previous videos, Kirsten and I are getting married. And no, it's not legal in the state of Florida, but if we were living in another state or another country, it wouldn't be a big deal, and we're still going to have a wedding. You know, just like as if we were living in a place where we were legally getting married, which in and of itself is a completely different topic. But it has to do with what I want to talk about this week. About a week ago or less, we were at a restaurant, one of the places that we do like to normally go eat lunch. And as I referred to in my last video, so I guess maybe it's been over a week now, the waitress came to give us the check, and I don't know, she had rung them up separately and then just placed both of them on the table, but Kirsten just so happened to be paying for both of our lunches. And so being the outgoing Leo that I am and have a propensity for saying things that maybe I shouldn't say sometimes, just out of being open, when she came back to get the checks, Kirsten had her credit card out and said just ring them both up together. And I can't exactly remember what the waitress said, but I said, oh no, she's paying because we're engaged. And I said it very lightheartedly, and I was smiling. And the waitress, now I don't know if I'm going to be able to quote her exactly, but it was something along the lines of, said back to me, too much information. You girls keep that between yourselves, what you guys do. And I don't need to know about it. And it was awkward at best, okay? Well, later on, when we came home, this incident led Kirsten and I to have a very deep discussion and very serious discussion about how uncomfortable that situation made us feel, her in particular. And we tried to talk about what the root of not just being able to blow her off was. And so some of the things that we came up with were growing up with the idea that being gay is shameful or there's something to be ashamed of. And now I didn't grow up with that as much as my partner did, and she had to grow up hearing that a lot. And so what happens is, over 4 decades or more, you really do get programmed and you do have this internalized shame and a lack of self-acceptance about who you are, because perhaps you've been told that there's something wrong with you because you are gay, especially if you're someone like my partner who has, come out when she was a teenager, basically. And so, I've thought a little bit more about this incident at the restaurant, and part of me, I guess, trying to give the waitress the benefit of the doubt, because she was kind of laughing when she said that back to me, part of me wants to think that she thinks I was joking, and then was taking it as, I don't want to hear what you girls are doing as a joke, like not believing that we were really a couple. Or she was very homophobic and was disgusted by the fact that we were together and that we were getting married. And that whole incident kind of really pissed me off, because if I were sitting there with a man and I said that, you know, another woman's response most likely would have been, "Oh my God, congratulations, how exciting, and I'm so happy for you two, when's the big day, blah, blah, blah." But people don't realize that even though in the state of Florida, my cat is just like messing with the camera, Wolfie, don't do that. Even though that we cannot legally get married in the state of Florida, we still have all the same emotions and feelings about our event as any other heterosexual couple would. So when someone tells us too much information and, you know, keep that to yourself, that was the other thing that she said. She says, "You keep that to yourself," or, you know, something like that. And she was kind of joking when she said it, so it wasn't like she was aggressive about it, but I think it was kind of, it struck me as a kind of a nervous laughter. So when someone says that to you, you feel like there is something that you're supposed to be ashamed of and we shouldn't be doing this. And deep down in our hearts, we do not feel that way. I have to just go by what I'm feeling inside, and the love that I have for her is so strong and so beautiful that there is no way that our love is wrong. And so that's something that we have dealt with in this past week. Now there's one other little thing that's kind of coming up now that we've been talking a lot about. Okay, so as you purchase things for a wedding, some of these things you cannot get unless you go to a wedding shop or a party store that has wedding items there. And yesterday we went to get a cake cutter, you know, because we're just trying to get little things as we can as we think of them. And after the incident at the restaurant, you know, I was bringing the cake cutter, and Kirsten was with me, up to the counter just praying that someone was not going to be inquisitive and ask me if I'm getting married, because I just wanted to buy it and then be gone. And you know, that really brings up another point. It's like, why should I have to out myself to every clerk and waitress and blah, blah, blah every time I just want to purchase something? So the problem that you then face is, if I'm asked this question, do I tell the truth and just let the chips fall where they may and see what the person's response is, or do I flat out lie? And I'm not a person who likes to lie. I don't lie. And this is really goes against every grain that I have inside my soul to not be truthful and to be unapologetic about it. But now all of a sudden I'm fearful of getting into that situation like we did with the waitress. So it's really tough, because you know, you just, again, we're forced to be put in a situation to base our actions on making somebody else comfortable. Now that is answering the part of the question about out of the closet. But the Jim was asking also is how self-acceptance impacted us when we were closeted as well. And it impacted me a lot when I was closeted, because the whole time that I was married to the couple different people, as you saw Sally's story, I thought there was something wrong with me. And I thought that there was a really serious reason why I could not commit to any of the men that I had been with before. And so while I was in the closet, the self-acceptance issue really came up quite a bit until I basically imploded emotionally. If anybody has any suggestions on how to handle perhaps these future encounters with sales clerks and stuff like that, when we're buying things that are clearly wedding related, I would really love to hear them. So thank you very much for watching, and have a great day. Peace.